In today's tutorial, I have a quick fire trick when using the offset path function, and it's one that many people often wonder how to do, so let's dive right into it in today's video. So welcome back to Satori Graphics, and in this second recent video on the offset path function, I'm going to show you a really neat trick when using typography. And if you want to see more videos with the powerful offset function in Illustrator, do let me know. But to demonstrate the problem in today's video, sometimes people want to have a full stroke around their text, but for that stroke to be set away from the type itself with a clear, visible gap in between. So one method people might adopt would be to come into the Appearance panel, then create a stroke, and then actually head into the Effects options and offset that stroke. However, with the preview option highlighted, we can see a clear problem, and that is the stroke overruns itself in many, many areas along the typography, and this doesn't look ideal at all. Well, I do have an efficient workaround which you're going to want to add into your workflow bank for future designs. So for this workaround, we do need to outline the text, so let's go ahead and do that first and foremost. The second step is to make a compound path, which you can find here, or you can press Ctrl or Command 8, which is the keyboard shortcut. The third step in this offset path workaround is to use the offset path function in the object drop-down menu. You obviously can adjust the settings to fit your typography and look at the detail of the inner lettering to see if it looks good for your design, and then hit OK. So now you're going to end up with something pretty much like this, and select the outer line with the outside stroke and apply a stroke in the color palette down here in the bottom left. Finally, for this part of the workaround method, select the inner type and then apply a color fill like so. So that essentially is the desired outcome, but I do have one awesome and one useful tip to show you when using this design. So after you've played around with the stroke weight, you might not be happy with how it looks, especially in the inner part of the typography. So simply come into the stroke panel here, or you can actually locate it in the window drop-down menu. But here you can change the orientation of the stroke in relation to the path itself. So it could be inside, in the middle, or on the outside. And this is going to change the appearance of your design until it meets your desired outcome. There is one other way of doing this, and it might apply to you and your workflow, because here I've got some typography that is outlined and it's already ungrouped. So of course, that means I came up to here, I outlined the text, and then I ungrouped it all. So yeah, I'm left with vector shapes that are not grouped together. If I this time go and use the compound path function, nothing appears to actually happen. The first method resulted in an invisible outline of my text. But if we then use the offset path, we have another different outcome as well. It's easy to see what has actually happened by coming into the layers window, because we have two shapes, one the original text, and then the offset chunkier version. With the thicker version, we have to simply flick it over to a stroke, and then the desired outcome has been achieved in a second different method. So this workaround is something many people want to achieve, but many cannot seem to accomplish. So I hope this short but sweet tutorial actually appeals to you when using offset path function with typography. Also, if you want to see more offset function tutorials, just let me know in the comment section down below, because there are more tips and there are more functions and uses that I do have for it in Illustrator. But of course guys, until next time, design your future today. Peace.